Hey everyone, today we are going to see detail about mailbox types in Microsoft Exchange Server 2013 and in 2016. There are different types of mailboxes are available in Microsoft Exchange Server. We are going to see detail about following type of mailboxes in Exchange Server 2013 and in 2016. First, we are going to see detail about arbitration mailboxes, or also known as system mailboxes. So the arbitration mailbox or the system mailbox are used for storing system data and for managing messaging approval data. And by default, when you deploy Exchange Server 2013 or 2016, 5 arbitration mailboxes or the system mailboxes get created. We are going to see detail about these 5 arbitration mailboxes, and we will see how it is utilized for storing system data and managing for messaging approval data. The first arbitration mailbox is Microsoft Exchange Approval Assistant. So the use of this arbitration mailbox is that before the email is get delivered to the user or distribution group, that email is saved or held by this arbitration mailbox if someone have set this type of rule. We will see this explanation with a diagram. Let's say you have set one particular rule on any particular distribution group or any end user or recipient, that before delivering the email, that email should be approved by some administrator or by manager. So unless and until that administrator or the manager approved that email, the email will be stay there only. After approval from administrator or the manager, the email will be get delivered to the end user or recipient or the distribution group. So if the administrator not approved or make some delay in approval of the email, then that email will be held by this type of arbitration mailboxes. After approval, the email will be delivered to the destination. Next arbitration mailbox is Microsoft Exchange. This arbitration mailbox is used in offline address book generation process. This type of mailbox is also known as your organization mailbox. So this mailbox is responsible for generating your address list in your organization. Next arbitration mailbox is Microsoft Exchange. This arbitration mailbox holds the administrator audit log report and store in-place e-discovery search metadata. Next arbitration mailbox is Microsoft Exchange Federation mailbox. This mailbox is used for federation between different organizations. This is specifically used for cross-premises, FreeBSD, and to form a federation between cross-forest organization. Next arbitration mailbox is Microsoft Exchange Migration. This mailbox holds the detail of mailboxes being moved in migration batches. So if you are moving mailboxes from one database to another database, or from one Exchange Server to another Exchange Server database, so that migration batches data will be stored in this type of arbitration mailboxes. You can check those detail like get move request, or if you want to check the status of migration, that status will be shown by these arbitration mailboxes. So if you have any issues related to messaging approval or generation of offline address book or the federation between different organizations, you need to first check the details of these arbitration mailboxes. And when you deploy a new Exchange Server 2013 or new Exchange Server 2016, by default 5 arbitration mailboxes will get created. These arbitration mailboxes were first introduced in Exchange Server 2010. You can check the arbitration mailbox detail by running this command get mailbox hyphen arbitration. If you have multiple Exchange Server in your environment, you can run the following command to verify the details of all the arbitration mailboxes and the arbitration mailboxes created per Exchange Server. It is recommended that you should not delete your arbitration mailboxes. Instead, you need to move the arbitration mailbox from one database to another database or to different Exchange Server before deleting our Exchange environment or the database where our arbitration mailboxes are hosted. If you are not able to delete these arbitration mailboxes by PowerShell command or from Active Directory, you can forcefully delete those arbitration mailboxes from ADSI edit tool. Next type of mailbox is user mailbox. User mailbox is one of the recipient type in Microsoft Exchange. The person having user mailbox in Microsoft Exchange, that user will able to store emails, will able to send and receive emails and can create meeting and appointments. With this, the user will get its personal storage for emails and for Outlook content as well. Each user mailbox have associated an Active Directory account. So there must be an Active Directory account present for users whose mailbox need to be created in our Exchange environment. In Microsoft Exchange Server, one email address can be assigned to only one user. You cannot assign one email address to multiple users in Microsoft Exchange Server. So, one mailbox per person. You can manage user mailboxes from Exchange Admin Center or from Exchange Management Shell as well. You can create new mailbox for existing user in Active Directory just by running this command. Enable mailbox identity. You need to provide account or the email address of the ID account and the database where the mailbox need to be stored. You can disable the mailbox just by running this command, disable mailbox, and you need to mention the email address or alias from ID account. If you want to delete the user mailbox, you just need to run this command, remove mailbox identity, and you need to provide the email address of the user. In disable mailbox, we will temporarily disable the mailbox of the user. After disabling the mailbox, the ID account of the user will be still there, but the user will not able to log in to his mailbox. And in delete mailbox, if you run the command remove mailbox identity, the email address of the user, the mailbox of the user will be get deleted from Exchange Server and the ID account of that user will also get deleted. So if you want to recover the mailbox of user, which we have removed with this remove mailbox command, you first need to restore the ID account of the user, then you need to restore the mailbox of the user. This does not happen in disable mailbox. In disable mailbox, the mailbox will be temporarily disabled. The user will not able to access the mailbox. If we enable that mailbox again, the user will able to access his email. Next is archive mailbox. Archive mailboxes are designed so that user can store historical message data outside their primary mailbox. So this feature is provided by Microsoft Exchange Server. This is just a secondary storage for your personal mailbox. You will get extra storage space apart from your personal mailbox. Emails can be moved by the end user to the archive mailbox or from Exchange Admin Center by applying retention policy move to archive on the user mailbox to automatically move the email after a certain duration. Let's say you have retention policy in your organization that the emails which are older than 2 years should be moved to archive folder so that you will get fresh email in your inbox or the primary mailbox. So your older email will be moved to this archive mailbox. You can access those emails from Outlook or from webmail as well. You can enable archive feature by Exchange Admin Center. You need to open the user mailbox whose archive you need to enable. Under mailbox feature tab, you can see archiving feature. Or you can enable this archive feature from Exchange Management Shell as well. If you want to enable the archive for a specific user, you just need to run this command in Exchange Management Shell. And if you want to disable the archive feature of the mailbox, you just need to run this command. Next is shared mailbox. As the name suggests, shared mailbox is a type of mailbox that multiple users can access for their shared purposes. This type of mailboxes are also known as common mailbox. From this shared mailbox or from this common mailbox, multiple users can send or receive emails if they have that type of permission or access on the shared mailbox. To look in more simpler view for shared mailbox, let's check this diagram. Here in this we have a common mailbox or the shared mailbox, and the user 1, user 2 and user 3 have access to this shared mailbox. If you have granted full access and sender's permission to these users, then these users will able to send email to inside the organization users or the internet user as well from this shared mailbox. And if anyone sends an email to this shared mailbox, then that email will be stored or delivered to this shared mailbox, and all these users will able to access, read or reply to those emails. We will see about permission details in next slide. You can access this shared mailbox from Outlook and from webmail as well. Here, for shared mailbox, you cannot log in to the shared mailbox. Instead, you log in to your personal mailbox, then you need to add the shared mailbox as a secondary mailbox in your Outlook, and then you can access. Next is about permission detail in shared mailbox. With having full access permission on shared mailbox, the user will able to access the shared mailbox, will able to delete and modify the email content in that shared mailbox. But with having full access permission, the user will not able to send email from that shared mailbox. To send email from the shared mailbox, the user must have sender's permission on that shared mailbox. With having sender's permission, the user will able to send email from the shared mailbox or reply to the email which is there in the shared mailbox. With having send on behalf permission, the user will able to send emails on behalf of the shared mailbox. The difference between this send as and send on behalf permission is that, let's consider you have a shared mailbox with having this email address common.mailbox@domain.com, and if we have sender's permission on this shared mailbox, and if you send an email, the from address will show as the shared mailbox email address. And if you have send on behalf access right, and if you have sent an email from the shared mailbox, then from address will show as user on behalf of this common.mailbox@domain.com. To access all feature without any issue, the shared mailbox should be auto mapped to user's Outlook profile. It should not be added manually to user's profile. So there are two ways to add the shared mailbox in your Outlook profile. To access all the feature, Microsoft suggests that you need to auto map the shared mailbox in your Outlook profile. You can grant access to shared mailbox from Exchange Admin Center or from Exchange Management Shell as well. You can create new shared mailbox from this tab, or you can create shared mailbox from Exchange Management Shell as well with command. Next type of mailbox is room mailbox or resource mailbox. So a room mailbox is a resource mailbox that is assigned to a physical location such as conference room, an auditorium or a training room. If you have meeting room in your organization, you need to have a mailbox for that meeting room, so that user can book the meeting room as per their schedule. So you need to have some mail enabled recipient for that meeting room, which is known as room mailbox. You can book those meeting room by sending meeting invite from Outlook or from webmail as well. You just need to select the room mailbox after creating meeting invite in Outlook and send that email to the room mailbox. If the room mailbox is available for the duration we mention in the meeting invite, a meeting acceptance email will be delivered to the sender. And if it is not available, then your meeting request will be declined. That email of acceptance and decline will be generated by this room mailbox. You can modify the setting as per your requirement for room mailbox. In this room mailbox permission, you can grant access to specific people, that only specific users will able to book the room mailbox, or the room mailbox will accept email from specific people only. You can create room mailbox from Exchange Admin Center or with PowerShell command as well. In this Exchange Admin Center, under Recipient tab, go to Resources. From here, you can create the new room mailbox. Next is Equipment Mailbox. An Equipment Mailbox is a resource mailbox assigned to a resource that is not location specific, such as portable computer, projector, microphone, or a company car. Let's say you have projector or surface hub or LED display. So these mailboxes have a mail enable object which is known as equipment mailbox. These mailboxes are different from room mailboxes. Equipment mailboxes are assigned to equipment in your organization. Equipment in the organization have their own mailbox, which we can book and utilize as per our requirement. So the booking process for equipment mailbox is same as the way we book the room mailboxes. You can create this mailbox from Exchange Admin Center or from Exchange Management Shell as well. Next is Discovery Mailbox. Discovery mailboxes are created to copy the discovered email by the eDiscovery search result. And this eDiscovery search are done for legal purposes in your organization. Now here the eDiscovery search you can perform to find the missing email for specified duration for any mentioned mailbox. So this eDiscovery search is used to search the email across all the mailbox content, including your deleted item and the original version of modified emails. After the eDiscovery search completes, you need to map or copy those discovered email to a mailbox, which is known as Discovery Mailbox. Exchange Server setup processes create a Discovery Mailbox by default. Administrator can create additional Discovery Mailboxes as per their requirement. So there will be by default one Discovery Mailbox created by the Exchange Server when you deploy a new Exchange Server. A Discovery Mailbox cannot be converted to a different type of mailbox. So you cannot convert Discovery Mailbox to a user mailbox or shared mailbox or any other type of mailbox. And a new Discovery Mailbox can have storage up to 50 GB of quota. An important thing to remember is that we cannot send an email to Discovery Mailbox, as these Discovery Mailboxes are hidden from global address list. You can check the details of Discovery Mailbox by following commandlet. So these are the details for different type of mailboxes in Microsoft Exchange Server 2013 and in Exchange Server 2016. If you have any questions or suggestions, please do let me know in the comment section. And finally, thanks for watching.